Hi, my name is Heather Slusser with the Marathon County UW Extension Office. Today we are going to talk about the third part in our four-part series on bull health and fertility. Today's topic is factors affecting bull health. There are five different factors that affect bull health and fertility. The first is structural soundness. The second is the capability of the reproductive organs. The third is the semen quality. Fourth, level of libido. And fifth, plane of nutrition. We will discuss each one of these in more detail. Structural soundness. You want to make sure that your bull has functional feet, legs, and associated joints. If he does not, he is unable to walk the breeding pasture and able to access all of the cows that may be available to him. You also want to make sure that the rear legs are not extremely straight. Having a moderate angle to the legs is necessary in order for the bull to mount and to thrust. The reproductive organs can be affected. If the testis is surrounded by lots of fat tissue, then the pampiniform plexus and the scrotum are not able to function effectively and allow for cooling. Scar tissue also affects cooling. Having a small scrotum also affects the bull's ability to lower his testis and to get his testicles away from the body. Soft testicles are a sign of degeneration, meaning that inadequate spermatogenesis may be occurring. Having small testicles is also a sign of unsatisfactory development of the testicles, indicating small or low sperm supply. Some common penile problems that occur in bulls are spiral deviation, persistent frenulum, and penile hair rings. Spiral deviation is where the penis is twisted instead of straight. A persistent frenulum is where the tip of the penis remains attached to the sheath and cannot be extended. A persistent frenulum is a genetic disorder but can be corrected by surgery. Penile hair rings are where a band of hair encircles the penis. This can cause scarring and infection if left untreated. Some other issues that can affect the penis are fractures, warts, and then scarring from previous injuries. Semen quality is also important to evaluate. When we look at semen quality, we're looking at both sperm morphology and sperm motility. Morphology refers to the structure of the sperm, while motility refers to the progressive forward travel of the sperm. It is not uncommon for poor sperm tests to occur in bulls less than 15 months of age. So you want to make sure that if you are testing a young bull and they fail the reproductive exam, that you continue to repeat tests for up to 4 months after puberty. This slide shows some common abnormalities in bovine sperm. You can see that the defects generally occur in the head or in the tail. Effects of high temperature also affect our sperm quality. After 8 hours or more of heat exposure, motility of sperm is significantly reduced. It has also been shown that after 16 hours of heat being applied to the scrotum, that DNA damage within the sperm has occurred. This was shown by a test that used normal eggs or eggs from females that had not been exposed to heat and sperm from males that had been exposed to heat. The result was significant embryo death caused by the DNA damage. Cold weather also has an effect on sperm quality. Cold weather decreases spermatogenesis, creates bulls that are subfertile, and then also allows for frostbite to occur on the scrotum. Frostbite on the scrotum causes scar tissue, which will hinder the cooling ability of the testis. Libido is the animal's sex drive. An animal that has low libido or low sex drive is not going to mate as many females as an animal with higher sex drive. You can measure the animal's sex drive or his libido based on his serving capacity. Serving capacity is the number of animals the bull will breed in a given period of time. Social interactions and social dominance also affect an animal's libido. Often, if you have more than one male, the dominant male will breed his select choice of females, leaving the other females for the other male to breed. The plane of nutrition of the bull is also important. During the breeding season, the bull will tend to eat less, since his mind is predominantly focused on breeding. Because the bull is not eating as much, he can use up his body stores of fat and lose up to 150 pounds of weight. It is important that our bulls come into the breeding season with a little extra condition so that by the end of the season, they are not under conditioned. When we look at our bull's ability to breed, we want to make sure that we are not overtaxing our bulls by giving them more females than they can handle. This chart is showing the number of cows a bull of average fertility can be expected to impregnate in a 60-day breeding season on pasture. So a yearling bull can be expected to breed 15 to 20 cows. A 2-year-old can breed 20 to 30 cows. A 3-year-old and greater can breed 30 to 40 animals.
Thank you for watching this video, and we hope you learned something.